Hi, in the next 10 minutes, I'm going to show you how to quickly create a automation account that will allow you to trigger a scheduled shutdown and start of your virtual machine. So first thing first, you need to go to the Azure portal, which is at portal.azure.com. Okay, and afterwards, you need to sign with your account. Okay, so over here, I'll sign in my live ID. And for the sake of time, I'll quickly switch over to assign the account. First thing that you need is that you need automation service. So just hit on the plus button, search for automation, okay, and select the automation. So there are two types of automation that can be found. Make sure you select the automation only, not the automation and control. Okay, so from here, you can just go ahead and hit create and give it a name. So for this, I'll maybe call it the Tunxiong demo. Okay, select a subscription and you can either put it in a new subscription group or use an existing subscription group. So for me, I'll create a new subscription group. Okay, the most important thing that you want to take note is that you will need to make sure that this is enabled as yes. So this is gonna be the account that will help you to run your PowerShell script on behalf of you based on the type that you have scheduled. So go ahead, hit on create, okay, wait a while and make sure that the accounts are all created properly. So it might take around 30 seconds, okay, and you can track your progress over here by clicking on the bell. So once that is done, you will see that you have two new accounts. One is a runless account for Azure resource management type of resources, and you have a classic one. The next thing, so now we have created the automation, we'll go ahead and look for the automation service. So you will go to your resource group, look for the resource group that you named previously. Just let me dismiss this. And over here you can see there are four default runbooks that have been created for you. These are not activated, so don't worry about it. If you want to delete them, you can delete and just by clicking it and then go to the tab and delete it. So what I want to do right now is that I want to create two new runbook, which is for shutting down and starting our VM. So let me go ahead, click on the automation account. Okay, go to the runbook, okay, and search for a template. Click on browse gallery, okay, and search for specifically version 2, V2, VM, and then you hit enter. Okay, so these are all the filters that are enabled by default. Let me just close this. There are two types of runbook that you can see over here. There's one that's based on graphics, okay, and then there's the other one that's based on PowerShell. So depending on preference, you can choose either the graphics one or the PowerShell one. So for this, I will show you the PowerShell one because I have already pre-created the PowerShell script for you. So go ahead, click on Start Azure VM. And what I need to do is that I need to copy this PowerShell script into my subscription. So I will do this by clicking the import, okay, hit OK, and then repeating this process for the stock VM as well. Okay, so let me go, oops, okay, let me go over to the stock VM runbook. Okay, copy over by clicking on import, hit OK, okay, and then done. So the next thing I want to do is that I want to customize the PowerShell script that is available on the start VM. Okay, so let me click on start VM. What I want to do now is I want to edit. Notice that most of these cursor at the top are all grayed out. Okay, these are intentional because when we originally copy over this PowerShell script, they are not published yet. We need to say they are not published to production for you to use. So first thing first, I want to edit it. Okay, and these are the PowerShell script. I'll provide you if some of these PowerShell script that are pre-written. Okay, this is for starting our VM. So I'll remove everything from here and then I'll paste. Walking you briefly through the code, okay, the most important part that you have here is the connection string. So remember previously when we created a subscription, there was this account that is called as new Azure run as account. Okay, this is the account itself. So this account will have the permissions to run all these scripts that you have at the bottom. So the behavior of this script is that, okay, the administrator who is going to schedule this timing of shutting down and starting up will have to put in the resource group name. Oops, sorry. We'll have to put in the resource group name, okay, or the VM name. If they just put in the resource group name, we assume that they want to shut down and start up all the VMs that's associated with a resource group. Okay. So once I'm happy with this, I can either do a test. Okay, so this is like the debugging tool for you to test is there any errors or some other flaw that you have in your coding of your PowerShell script. Okay, once you're happy with it, okay, hit on save. Okay, remember save does not do anything yet, you have to publish to be able to use it. So right now I'm happy with this, I'll hit a publish, hit okay. Okay, and now you see the top, I can start to schedule this workload. So I also understand that sometimes we have different type of workloads that we want to start and stop at different time. So let's say I have my two customer, customer 1 and customer 2, they might have two different timing of when they start work, right? Okay, so let's say for schedule, okay, I can say, hey, I want to schedule a start resource for this customer A. Okay, so this is customer A start PM. Okay, and I'll say maybe they start their work at 8 a.m. Okay, and I cannot have things that's happened in the past, so I'll put in one day later, and I'll make it a recurring event. I'll make it recur every 24 hours at 8 p.m. I'll make sure all the VMs are started, okay, and it will never expire. Okay, next thing I'll need to put in is of course something dynamic, which is the VM name and resource name. So remember previously when we created the script, we needed the administrator, who is you, to enter the VM name and resource name. So let's say if this customer has I just want to shut down and start one VM, okay, which is named VM1, which is in customer A resource group. Make sure that this, okay, actually matches the specific workloads that you really have on the subscription. If not, it will not work. Okay, okay, and I'll say okay. Okay, so this is for customer A, and the beauty about this is that you have multiple schedule for a single run book. Okay, so I can schedule to say, okay, hey, I want customer B to have their VM started in the morning as well, but not as early. I'll say maybe this is like maybe 9:30 a.m. Okay, starting from tomorrow. 9:30 a.m. Okay, I'll say this is customer B startup. Okay, and then do it recurring as well. Do it 24 hours. You can put it as one day as well, or can do by weeks. Okay, do a create. Okay, and then say this might be a VM1. Okay, and the resource group might be customer B resource group. Okay, hit on okay. Okay, and then you are done. Okay, this is as simple as it is. So to complete the whole cycle of doing the shutdown as well, let me go to the stop VM script. Okay, same thing, I'll go and edit it. Okay, remove the pre-created script and use the script that I provided. Okay, you can change it to behave in the way that you want to. Okay, this is just a very simple template to just log in. Okay, check out what has the user entered, and then shut them all down. So I'll do a save and then publish. Yes. And maybe for shutdown, I would say maybe customer A and customer B, or most of the people will have a similar shutdown timing. I can go ahead and say, hey, for this shutdown schedule, okay, I want all VMs to shut down at the same time at 10. So instead of having two rules, I can say shut down all VMs at 10 p.m. Okay, say I put in 10 p.m. Okay, starting from tomorrow. Okay, recurring, no expiration, and 24 hours. Okay, and then for the parameters, so remember the behavior of the PowerShell script is that if I don't put in the VM name, but I put in the resource name, everything under the resource name will be shut down. But if I don't put in the VM name and I don't put in a resource name, all VMs in my subscription will be shut down. So if I want that behavior to be before, I can just hit OK and hit OK, and there you go. I have a customized type of scenarios for different type of customers based on the runbook that I have.